I don't think that much as you want to stamp your authority, you want to stamp out in discipline in a national team setup, you should go to such ridiculous extents in doing so. Mm. Really, it should not be made a media circus.
But however, we need to be careful because, like we said, nobody has actually seen the content of the contract, the structure or what the contract looks like with between Steve Keshi and the NFL. We don't know what was agreed. But he has actually come out to say, now, what Bada has said or he's saying is, and what I think he said, that he has come out to say that he did not apply for the job. So, dead dog should be allowed to stay buried, or sleepy dog should be allowed to lie. Is that what you think? Do you agree with Bada?
When you insinuate that we've not seen the terms of the contract, what are you trying to say? That if he had signed that he wasn't going to apply, if he is holding on to a job, then it means he's guilty as charged. What Bada is saying, and which I agree to, is there's so much reality show coming out of this. There's so much drama, melodrama coming out of all of this. If you want to find out if Keshi did apply, and there's nothing stopping anybody from even shortlisting anybody in the world, I can sit down here and shortlist Jose Mourinho for my team. It is a shortlist. Nothing stops me from picking who I want to pick. At the end of the day, has he got the job? No. You can actually place a phone call to the Ivorian FA to find out if he actually applied, if you want to do some fact-finding mission. But Keshi himself has come out to deny it. What more do you need? It seems there is a plot to hang this guy. You're giving him a bad name just to hang him. What are his offenses? You didn't like him ab initio anyway. So what is all the melodramatic movement all about? So I think it is a non-issue.
So if you guys talk like this, then why do you think the NFL would have employed him, given him the opportunity?
I think it was foisted on them. It was absolutely.
But they've come out several times that they were not.
We're not foolish people. there's a reason we have brains that work. And they can say what they care. What they are saying, what they are doing now, further confirms our suspicions. If, like Larry says, or said rather, if your reason is not to witch hunt a human being or an employer, or employee rather, why would you be going to this ridiculous extent of sending people to Cote d'Ivoire to go and find out if it was the one that personally submitted an application, or if it was someone who did on his behalf? So if you find out that he submitted an application for the job, what does that mean? You're going to fire him on that basis because he's breached his contract? Come on, it's ridiculous, really. The best that this would reveal is whether or not the NFF are willing to work with Steven Keshi going forward. Because if they do punish him on the basis of him supposedly applying for a job he didn't even get ultimately, then it probably will be the most ridiculous sacking Nigeria has witnessed at this level.
Okay, now I'm lost for words because I mean, we did argue at some point in time that asking Amode to actually come and be in charge of the team selection, it was maybe not in exact words, but we understand that he must work with Steven Keshi. A lot of people have actually insinuated that might be married Gonzalo later on. I mean, they don't see these guys
agreeing
to a lot of things. So, I mean, guys are allowed to actually speculate, but our duty is to actually look at the facts and figures and let people know that this is what the situation is.
I think the NFF should begin to major in the major things. Right now, they are majoring in the minor things, and I'm really worried.
They're chasing shadows, really.
I'm really worried.
What's your business with your coach who was shortlisted? As Wenger can be shortlisted in France, in Real Madrid.
How many times
would Arsenal go and ask Real Madrid, oh, did you guys, did As Wenger apply?
I even heard
that should it be established that Steven Keshi didn't put in for that job, there is a chance the NFF are looking to report the Ivorian Federation to FIFA for poaching. How ridiculous can you get?
I'm sure this issue will not go away, but let's see what the coming week will give us as regards this matter. I'm sure when Ken comes back, he probably has one or two things to say as regards that matter too as well. Thank you. But let's talk about the Copa America. The Copa America is actually coming to an end. It's been played. It's in Chile. And Chile looked very good to actually lift the trophy for the first time. That would be the first time should they go ahead and lift it. Not only Chile, Paraguay as well too. Should they go ahead and play in the finals and win? That probably will be their first time too as well. Now, the results of the games that took place in the early hours of yesterday night was Argentina playing Colombia. The game ended 5-4 in favor of Argentina. They left it late. Messi did not score in regulation time, but he had a beautiful penalty kick. Colombia lost out on that penalty. Brazil, the almighty Brazil, you thought that they would have gone ahead to make a statement with the way Dunga brought some life back to them after they lost 7-1 into Germany. But unfortunately, it wasn't to be. They lost on penalty as well, too.
Yeah, they lost the penalties, and it was exactly how it played out 4 years ago in Argentina when Paraguay dumped Brazil out of that competition. The key curious thing about this Paraguayan team is that the last 10 games in the Copa America, they've only won one of it, and that was the game against Jamaica. The last time out, when they finished runners-up, they actually didn't win a game. How ridiculous is that? They didn't win a game. And this time around, they won one, and they found themselves in the semifinals again. They pick their moments, and they get lucky sometimes. Yeah. For most part, yesterday, they were riding their luck, really. Yeah. Even though, it must be said, Brazil went effervescent. They weren't really boisterous. They weren't really on the front foot and creating chances like
we thought they would. Thiago Silva, I mean, really.
For the second time this season, in a crucial game, first off against Chelsea in the Champions League, even though he didn't make up for that by scoring the winning the goal that proved the winning goal ultimately. But yesterday, it was just pure madness. He had no business getting his hand to the ball at the point where, even if the Paraguayan had gotten his head to the ball, he was never going to score a goal in a million years. So it was just a case of lack of concentration. And he was just being stupid, really.
And that's why some people have actually argued that's why he was stripped of the captain's man, giving back to Neymar.
Exactly.
He loses concentration at some point.
Exactly. And he didn't even start this tournament. He started on the bench. In their very first game, it was Miranda and David Luiz that started until David Luiz did what David Luiz does, which is to give the opposition a goal. Mm. But again,
that's the situation.
Yeah, that was it. That was a penalty call. Like I said, it was bizarre. It was. He looked innocent, but he knew what he was doing, or he didn't know what he was doing. Because I mean, how do you do that in modern day football? Really, what I was going to say though is that, on the strength of the four teams that have made their way into the tournament finals, I think that the Chileans have looked the most impressive, followed by the Argentines. The Chileans have scored 11 goals. Mm. The Argentines have scored 4 goals. Yeah. And then maybe followed by Peru, who scored 3 against Bolivia. And Paulo Guerrero is looking, you know, like he might be back to the form that saw him win the highest goal scorer award at the last Copa America. Okay. So I think that it would be good to see a final between Argentina and Chile. That will be a fitting finale for this competition.
All right, now about the future, that's what comes as we begin to round off right now. Chile will take on Peru in the first semifinal. The second semifinal will be between Argentina and Paraguay. It's a game we'll look forward to. I mean, you can't ignore Paraguay right now. I mean, they actually are dumped. People use that word a lot, Brazil out, so you probably will fancy them, and they will fancy the chances against Argentina as well. To Chile, Peru, you might be tempted to want to say Chile because of the home support and the way that I said they've been playing. But for you, I mean, you see these games, what do you think will happen eventually?
Matter of fact, the Copa America is one tournament that the more you look at it, the less you understand. All the teams are so closely knit in terms of their culture and their tradition. It's very difficult for you to see a team bash another three. Apart from Jamaica and Mexico that came into that tournament, it always very, very, very tight. And I expect another very tight game between Chile and Peru. What Chile has got going for themselves is the fact that they're hosting one, and then they have the likes of Vargas, Sanchez, and then Vidal. So those are magical men that can make it work at any moment in that game. But for Peru, they have Guerrero, of course, who has scored last tournament. I expect Chile to go through because they're host, and then they have three magical men who could turn the tide at any point in time. But for Argentina, Paraguay, Argentina needs to be very, 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 very careful. I'm emphasizing that. He mentioned the fact that Paraguay have not lost. They went to the final in the last edition. As a matter of fact, in that last edition in 2011, they drew all their group games, qualified as the third best loser in that from that point on, and then they went up to the final without drawing and then they lost eventually to Uruguay. But Argentina needs to be careful. If Argentina does not win that game in regulation time, lottery of penalties, Paraguay may just be
Let's add that both of them actually played the first group game. Mm-hmm. Argentina sprung into a 2-goal lead, but Paraguay pegged them back late on, 2 goals from I think Santa Cruz and Lucas Barrios. So we've seen it before. Argentina know what to do. If they play well to their potential, Argentina will win that quite easily.
Should Messi actually wrap it up? Should actually step up that day too. I'd like to say thank you so much, guys. Thank you for being a part of the segment as always. Now, before I let you guys go, there's this rumor that Che going to Arsenal. That is
actually rumor. It's confirmed.
He's doing his medical. I just checked if he has done his medical check.
What did the doctor tell you?
For Peter Check.
Peter Check is checking in.
Thank you for being a part of the segment. We need to go right now. Till we come here again next week. I don't go anywhere. The show continues. We're gonna break that. When we come back, Ken will be back to take you through the rest of the game, to the rest of the show. Join us again.
The comment made by Vincent Yama, if I tell you what it cost us in terms of enhancing, because what when he made that comment, it heightened security situation in Kaduna. So we had to go back to the drawing board and make sure that every other thing has to be arrested in terms of security. We need to enhance our security operations. We need to do a lot of things. So just making a careless statement cost us a lot of money. Nobody is bigger than Nigeria, and that's the gospel we preach. You can imagine, even among the players, I notice they are not friends. We'll find out A to Z. If he's found to be true, then he's in for serious trouble. But if it's not, then we'll continue. But we, because he signed the contract, we are not owing him. I can tell you that 100%. We tried to meet all our obligations to him, because, and he started on a very good note. You know, he won the game against Chad, and we intend to build on that. But it will be suicidal, so to speak, for him to say he wants to go and seek for unemployment where you have unemployment with a bigger and a more footballing nation. You know, so we'll just look at it. Like, again, it's not all about me. It's about the Federation. It's what the Federation wants, you know. When they bring it to your notice, you mail it out to the relevant authorities. They will invite him. They will talk to him and carry out their own investigation. And if indeed he applied, then the recommendations from the disciplinary committee and other committees will speak for itself.